Everybody showing off these new Transformers Studio Series figures, and I'm showing off one that came out last year.
But I like him.
Hey guys and gals, I'm here with a video. Today it is on the Transformers Studio Series 45 Drift. I have not gotten a Drift figure up to this point. I have not liked what they've made. This one, I'm a pretty big fan of. I like the overall helicopter mode. It's robot mode, I think, is the best looking out of all of them. If you do want to see the packaging, really quick, there you go. Hope that was enough for you. So I like that there is so little kibble in this helicopter mode. If you look underneath, if you know what you're looking for, yeah, you got some little robot bits there. You got a chest up inside there. But everything kind of tucks itself away very nicely. These are his arms. His legs are folded up, or are expanded here. These are his thighs, maybe his shins. I think his shins. But everything is just tucked away. And there's a little face just peeking, just saying hi. How you doing? I like this. I like this a lot. Now, I think this is a heavy retooled from the Dropkick figure that came out. I never got Dropkick, so I can't really compare the two. But I like it. I like the kind of see-through blue windshield. The rotors spin very well. And it makes what I can definitely pretend to be a helicopter sound when it's going. Tickles me. He does have these little missile pods that you can take off. They're just connected by the 5mm pegs, and you could move them up to the front if you wanted, or any place there are 5mm pegs. I think that's the only actual place for this mode. He's got two little guns at the front. He's got this tail rotor that I'm not a huge fan of, but hey, you know what? It's there. If you take it off, he kind of looks a little strange, a little nakey, and just gonna put that right back onto there. I like this guy a whole lot. So if you want to see a quick comparison, how he looks with other vehicles, I got a little progression for you. We got a Studio Series figure. We got a Last Night figure. And then we got an 07 movie figure. That may not tell you much, but you know, comparisons are nice. So let's transform this guy. First, you're going to take the two large rotors, pull them off, one pegs in a little tighter than the other, and you're going to take what's left, and it's going to just fold up on itself just like that. Go around to the back, take off the tail rotor, take off the missile pods, and then you're going to unpeg this whole front section. So that's going to come loose. It's going to come down. You can go ahead and fold up the little wing sections. And then this whole thing, once you get this unlatched, it's got two little tabs that hold into this back piece. Not very well, but it doesn't really need to. Just go ahead and fold these up. And then you're going to go and take this section and just kind of fold this up on itself. I'm a little concerned. It looks like this whole piece is clear blue plastic that's painted black. So I'm mildly concerned about how that joint's going to hold up over time. And maybe if you're too rough with it, which you probably shouldn't be. But that's just going to fold up. And once you get it a certain way, there you go. You have to kind of like angle it up and then back. That collapses on itself. And you might think you're done, but you're going to go ahead and go around. You're going to grab this whole section, which maybe you want to leave the little wing bit out. Just have something to grab onto. It's not necessary. But this is going to actually rotate around. And then when that's flipped around, you can fold the actual landing pad, strut, leg, whatever, in on the back. And don't forget to tuck in the little gun bit. It just kind of folds back like that. So that when that's done, there's your leg. There's your little leggy. So go to this side, do the whole same thing again. I'm going to go ahead and fold the gun up now, just to make it a little easier. So again, that's just going to fold up, and once you get it to there, you have to kind of nudge it forward a little bit so that it collapses, and it didn't work out on the first try. So that's, of course, going to flip back around, tuck that back, and there you go. There's Drift. So these are going to rotate around, just go ahead and do it now. And you can have your little Gurwalk. People love the whole Gurwalk stuff. You can do your Gurwalk. If you want to do the Gurwalk, you can do the Gurwalk. You can Gurwalk all day long. I don't know why I do the things I do. But anyway, so you're going to take this whole section. It's going to kind of come up and then fold over. And then when you get it around this, it just rests. And that's what keeps his little daggers in place for robot mode. You can't remove them, but It's fine. And then you take this whole thing and rotate it around, hitting Drift with his own arms, unpeg them, and go ahead and bring them down. So this is where it gets a teensy bit tricky. Just a teensy bit. So the arms are going to fold down on themselves, and then they're going to fold up, and they're going to bring them around to the sides. I hope that made sense. But again, just tuck, just fold and tuck. And you're going to squeeze those in so they fill out his chest area. And then from here, you're going to take the arms and you're going to rotate them around like that to reveal his fists. These don't really kind of peg in, they just kind of do whatever. But then when you get that all done, just get him all straightened up, get his hands facing the right direction, get his shoulders all the lines, and you have yourself a Drift that's not fully transformed because this moved on mine. There you go. Now he's fully transformed. And I really, really like this guy's robot mode. He has the right proportions to Drift. He's got that slender frame. I like this so much. If I might totally be wrong and talking out of my butt, but I think the previous Studio Series Drift was just a repaint of his Age of Extinction car mode. And while I like Drift having a car mode more, the robot just looked horrible. This looks like Drift. I really, really like it. But of course, if you want, you can make him look a little worse. You do have these excess missile pods, and you have these little ports that were on the helicopter mode of the front section. You can put those right in there if you want. I can't say I'm a big fan. I like Drift having a slender frame, and that just kind of bulks him up. And then you have the tail section that you can either put on his arm here. I'm not sure which way it's actually supposed to go, or if it really matters. We're going to try it the other way because that looks kind of dumb. And we're going to just put that right in there. It still looks dumb, but whatever. A lot of people can say you can use this as kind of like a shield while he's holding his swords. You can give him a spinny shield. I don't like it. I'm really not a fan of this. So you can store it on his back section, which I like a lot. And it just goes right there. I've seen some reviews, because I was curious about this guy beforehand, that complained about him making his backpack super big. And you know, if he can't stand, that's a concern to have. But I don't mind the actual look of the backpack. And I think he does stand okay once you get him balanced right. My table is not the most stable surface, but as a backpack, I don't mind it. Personally, for me, I just take off that. I take off the little missile pods, and I leave Drift just stripped down. I like how he looks so much more just like this. Now, he does have his two additional swords that I'm not sure if you could figure it out. He can hold them. Yeah. He's got holes in his hands, and he's got pegs in his swords. And you can have him holding his swords. So that's always nice. You can get him, you know, in your typical samurai poses. I think that's how samurais wield their swords. They just run around screaming like that. If you want to store the swords in robot mode, you have these little, they're very, very subtle kind of prongs on the sides. And if you look closely on Drift, he's got these little itty bitty slits. You know, it's almost like it was designed to go together. And I just dropped a sword, so that's kind of frightening because I don't know where it wound up. But you can peg them onto his thighs or his hips and have that really nice look going. I've mentioned it before, especially with Power Rangers. I like casual stances. I don't always want to have a battle stance for my Transformers. So if I can have him just doing a casual pose, just, you know, waiting for orders, I'm going to take it. I don't have to track down old Billy Boy here. We can just peg them in. You can see they don't hold in very firmly. They're not the best fits. I mean, once you get them in, they hold well enough if you shake the figure, but if you tap them just the slightest bit, they're gonna fall out. And I'm having more issues than I probably should have after a bit of fiddling. So there he goes with his swords sheathed kind of on his hips. Now, shake them, they're pretty sturdy, but it's just the slightest little nudge and they fall out. So I feel like this could have been implemented a little bit better, but the fact that it's there, it does make me happy because that's how I would like to have Drift displayed The daggers not being removable is okay. I don't need him to have four weapons. But yeah, this is just a really, really great looking figure. The face sculpt, I think, is top notch. I love it. I love his overall slender frame. This is what Drift should be. So articulation wise for him, let's just zoom out a little bit. He's got a lot of ball joints. You go up to his head, and there's like a slight tilting up and down action, and rotation. Like, it feels like it's trying not to rotate, but I can nudge it a little bit. It may just be a really tight joint, but there is some movement there. You go to his shoulders; they're ball joints. They can move around. They can do all kinds of stuff. Due to how he transfers, he has that added hinge inside, so they can go up pretty far. He does have an elbow joint. No wrist, no waist. The legs can go forward, they can go back, they can go out to the sides. They're ball joints. They do what ball joints can do. He does have knee articulation, and that's it. Everything down below is just static. There's nothing. So he's fairly poseable. I'm glad that he is sculpted with those little kind of slanted feet, so he's always going to have his feet planted on the ground firmly. I wonder how he can balance. You know, I see a lot of videos every now and then where they've got the figures, all these crazy poses. And I'm just like, no. But I'm curious how well a samurai will be able to balance with slanty toes. Nope. Slanty toes. His feet, I'm not going to allow for that kind of action. That was kind of cool, I guess. But for a size comparison, let's go ahead and get Drift all ready to go. All right, we'll get him right there. And like before, here we have a Studio Series. Here we have a Last Knight. And here's an original straight from the 2007 line. You can see the actual, like, progression. I should have done these better. We're gonna switch you. There you go. You can see how they've gradually gotten smaller over the years, from 2007 to whenever the heck the Last Knight came out, I don't know, and then to the Studio Series. There is definitely a smaller scale, and I figured, you know, why not just show more. Here's an Optimus, just to show how these guys look together. I like Drift a lot. I went up a little too high. I expected more out of Optimus. I like this figure a lot. If you are a fan of the Drift character from the movies, if you just want a nice little robo samurai, I think he looks great. It is unfortunate that these guys are such a smaller scale than even the Last Knight was. That kind of bummed me out a little bit. I don't like having to rebuy figures just to have them fit together. But I do really like him, and I'm glad I held off on getting a Drift all this time, because he's magnificent. If you want to find your own Drift, he seems fairly common. I got mine off Walmart.com. EntertainmentEarth.com does not have Drift, but they do have a lot of the other Studio Series figures, whether they've already been released or whether they're pre-orders. I'll have a link to them down below if you want to start getting some Studio Series figures. I thank you guys for watching if you've made it this far. If you enjoyed this video and you want to see more, I got a little subscribe thing doobie there. I got some previous videos over there, and I got a Patreon doobly-doo down below. If you pledge just $1 a month, you get access to behind-the-scenes looks, upcoming video ideas I have, and now I'm going to try to post schedules on there. And we have a Discord server. I hope I have a great day, and I will see you around. Take care.